Hi, this is Ouma Bernard, and thank you for being part of this channel. Now, in this video, I'm going to talk about the body paragraph of a literary essay. In the previous videos, I've been talking about the introduction and the topic sentence in the body paragraph. This video, therefore, is a follow-up on the discussion concerning the topic sentence. So by the end of this video, you will be in a position to write the body paragraph correctly. So let's move on. When we talk about the body paragraph, we simply mean the second, third, fourth, and fifth paragraphs after the introduction. These are the ones that carry the bulk of the marks, 12 marks. A body paragraph consists of a topic sentence, supporting sentences, and the clincher sentence. And it is how you write these sentences and weave them together that will earn you marks eventually. So, welcome to this discussion, and I believe it is going to be highly informative for you. So, what do we have in the body paragraph? Let us consider the question that we have been exploring. And here it is. Self-sacrifice must be rewarded. Basing your illustrations on A Doll's House by Henrik Ibsen, discuss the truth in this statement. So as we had already said in the previous videos, that you look at the two sides of the question. Here we have the self-sacrifice and how it is rewarded. Apart from the two sides, you also would want to know the characters that are involved, because this story is about people. These are the characters that make things happen. So who are the characters that make sacrifice in A Doll's House, and how are they rewarded? So in that case, we can consider characters like Nora, Mrs. Lind, Krogstad, and Nurse Anne. Once you have the characters and you have the two sides, you can go ahead and write a very good topic sentence and back it up with the supporting sentences and finally the clincher sentence and come up with a very good body paragraph. Let us therefore talk about the supporting sentences. These are the sentences that answer the question, giving detailed evidence from the text. Remember, the key word here is detailed evidence. So you must have read the text widely and wildly for you to be in a position to give factual and textual evidence that will back up your discussion to earn you the marks. All right? They answer the questions what, who, why, and how in relation to the text. So when we are talking about A Doll's House, for example, so what is the sacrifice? Who makes the sacrifice? Why? And how? It is the answer to these questions that build up a paragraph. So let us always have at the back of our minds when answering questions based on set texts. What is that thing that is happening? Like here we are talking about sacrifice. So who, what is the sacrifice? Who makes this sacrifice? Why does this character choose to make this sacrifice? And how does it happen? And how does it reward the character? That is what will bail us off in an exam situation. Okay? So from the moral statement that we have, self-sacrifice must be rewarded. What is the sacrifice? Who makes the sacrifice? Why does the character make this sacrifice? How is the sacrifice made? And what is the reward? That is what will bail us out. So the candidate should give enough textual details in order to score full marks. Enough textual evidence. I now want us to look at an example of a good body paragraph that has a topic sentence, supporting sentences, and clincher sentences. Let us go straight ahead. So the clincher sentence is the last sentence in a paragraph. It ties up or summarizes the candidate's argument in each paragraph. It demonstrates that the candidate has fully understood the question. So, though the clincher sentence might not earn you marks per se, but it is a clear sign that you have read the text, you have interacted with the text, and can respond very comfortably to a question based on the text. So it is good practice for good writers to have a clincher at the end of the paragraph that will tie up everything that they have discussed. Let us see. So, an example of a clincher sentence would be, "It is therefore Nora's great sacrifice that saves both her husband's life and her marriage." You can realize there that the clincher sentence just echoes the topic sentence, giving it more weight. So, as I've already said, we will be looking at full body paragraphs in the next video. Please don't miss the next video, because that is where we will be having a full essay for you. But for today, we have explored the topic sentence, supporting sentences, and clincher sentences. So, a full essay will be uploaded in the next video. Purpose to watch it. Are you enjoying these videos? Please hit the subscribe button below. Like this video. You will give me more courage to write more of these and to prepare more videos like this, so that we assist the candidates and we assist teachers in handling literature questions. So please like my videos, subscribe to my channel. I'll really be glad. And you also make your comments on the comment section below. Be sure that I will reply, and I will be very happy to see your comments. So I have been your teacher, Ouma Bernard. My contacts are on the screen. Please, you can call me. I have some programs. I have some good programs for KCSE candidates for this year. Yeah, I have very good programs that can assist them revise for KCSE even while at home. So make a point of calling me or hitting my inbox on Gmail, omabeniste@gmail.com, and I will guide you on how a candidate can prepare very well for this year's English examination and perform well, score the A grades that all students always want. Thank you very much for watching this video, and make sure you come back for the next video. If you missed out on the previous ones, just browse this channel and watch them right from the introduction. And as I promise, the next video will be a full essay based on A Doll's House, answering the question, "Sacrifice must be rewarded," the one that we've been exploring. Thank you once again, and goodbye for now.